Okay, today I just wanted to take a look at the Samsung T7 Shield external SSD drive. So for me, this is a drive I already own and I already use for editing. So anytime I'm away from my desk, I'll have one of these drives. You can probably just about see in the background, I've got a dash drive. So when I'm working at my desk, I'm using that. But when I'm away from it, I'll use one of these portable SSDs. And the reason I've bought a second one is because I wanted a dedicated drive just for the Panasonic GH6. And although this one is not currently on the supported list, it is under it is being tested at the moment. So hopefully it will be on the list short enough. And I don't see a reason why it shouldn't be, really, because it's a much quicker drive than the T5, and the T5 is currently in the supported list. So you know, if anything were to happen and it didn't make it on there, I will still just use it as a external drive anyway, so it doesn't make a great deal of difference. But it's a drive that I just really like, because it's in comparison to the T5, the T5 uses a sort of older USB. I believe on the T5 it's 3.1 Gen 2, so that's it's about 540 megs a second, whereas this is the USB 3.2, which the GH6 can actually support. And with that, you'll get transfer speeds, you know, pretty much double the T5, so nearly over 1,000 megs a second read and write. So it's a much better spec drive. So like I say, I'm hoping it just ends up on the supported list soon, because I don't really want to have to be buying older drives to work with the camera. It's one of those things where I'd rather just have, you know, a newer drive that's more capable. So especially if they add new modes in the future as well, they're a little bit more intensive. So this drive, I've bought it with my own money. It's not a sponsored video. Like I say, I already own the drive. There'll be links to it in the description, which will be affiliate links, but again, it's not, you know, this isn't a sponsored video. This is just my kind of preference of what I'm using as a drive. So these drives, this one cost me, it was £110, and I managed to get cash back on it as well. So it worked out to sort of just under 100, and that's for a 1 terabyte version. The 2 terabyte version comes in more around sort of £200, that kind of mark. 2 terabyte, really, for me, for this purpose, is probably slightly too much. I don't really need 2 terabytes, and because I'm going to be using it on the camera, it's quite likely going to be getting formatted quite often. You know, every time I've done a job or finished something, it's more than likely just going to get formatted and restarted again. Anywhere over sort of a terabyte of footage generally is too much for me to be working with. So I'm fairly confident that that's going to be enough, at least for me anyway. So what I'm going to do basically is we're just going to sort of jump into this one, and we're just going to format it and set it up, so we can just do a quick, you know, how to get an SSD set up with the GH6. It's I mean, my kind of preference on this drive is over the other T7 drives. There's there's actually 3 different drives in this kind of series. There's the normal one's just called the T7, and then there's a T7 Touch, and this one's called the T7 Shield. And the only reason I prefer this one over there is just literally because of this rubberized casing. You know, it's just it's supposedly drop resistant to 3 meters, which obviously I'm not going to be trying out. But you know, if it does fall off the camera for any reason, or you know, falls out of my bag or off a table, at least I'm a little bit more confident that it's not going to break. So it's for me, that's just a kind of a nice little feature, and it's quite a good versatile drive as well, because you've got the you get your 2 cables with it. So that's the cable you'll need if you want to use it with a GH6. So it's a USB-C to USB-C cable, and if you've got, you know, just a general laptop or desktop that uses USB-A, then you've got that, and that one obviously into the drive. So it's got a couple of uses, because like I say, if you start using this with the with your camera, you can always just format it again and use it as a desktop drive, or however you want to use it. And the cable is much better than the one with the so this is the E61. I mentioned in another video, this is the cable you get with the E61, which is absolutely tiny, so you can see the difference in, well, actually you can't, sorry, it's just a much bigger cable. So, and it's the good quality cables that you get with it, you know, it's designed for the drive, so you know it's going to work well. So what we're going to do is I'll just put it into this magic rig. Obviously you don't necessarily need to have anything like this, it's just to get it set up so it fits quite nicely into this. I'll leave a link for like this kind of thing below. This is somebody pointed out, this is actually quite similar to the small rig universal holder, so I'll leave a link to that down below. So yeah, what we need to do, obviously to do this, we're going to be using the new firmware version 2.2. So if you haven't installed that yet, you'll have to get yourself over to the Panasonic website, download the update and everything for it, and you know, get all of that kind of done. I'll link above to a video on how to do that if you're sort of unsure how to get it to there. But if you're not on that firmware, you're not going to actually see the options that we're looking at in this, so you'll need to do that. Normally as well, I'd probably be using, you know, a cable tidy that comes with the cage, or you know, kind of sort this out, because you don't really want just like a big wire hanging off the side, because you know, if that gets pulled or anything, if it pops out of the drive or pops out of the camera, or you know, worse still, if it bends the cable in the camera, then you know, that's a problem. You don't want a broken port, and you also obviously don't want to lose your footage. So, you know, just make sure everything's kind of tidy when you're working with it. But let's jump into the camera. So we've got, if we go down to the wrench or the spanner, and then the top one, it's card and file. And then you can see there, we've got the option for USB SSD, and we can switch that on. It'll just say, please wait. And now it should come up and ask us to format the drive. So because it hasn't been formatted in the camera, it's given us that error. If we go up to USB SSD format, so you can see these are just the sort of two extra options that we've got now. And then there's nothing on the drive, so it's not a problem. And then you can see down here, we've got the SSD option is now enabled. So we should be able to just go to switch that off. And then you'll see when we switch it back on, it shouldn't be giving us that kind of message that we got before. There we go. So you can see SSD down at the bottom. We switch it off. It takes a little bit of time to do it, which can be a little bit of a pain kind of switching in and out of it. But and then you can see we're back to our standard cards there at the bottom. So if we switch it on again, and then we can just shoot like we kind of normally would. So if I just do, or I'm probably too far away to actually shoot anything. So bit of blurry footage of a drive. And then when I come back into playback, you can see we've actually got our SSD here. Now, it's worth bearing in mind as well, I'm going to do a video that kind of runs over the ins and outs of this, but it's kind of switched over entirely in the way it does playback and the way it records things. So there's a few things you kind of need to bear in mind when you're using SSD recording. But what I'll do is I'll do a bit of a follow-up video on, you know, how I've been working with it and how, you know, it's sort of maybe going to be useful in my workflow. But yeah, that was just a bit of a quick video on what drive I'm planning to use, and you know, how it's going to be, you know, mounted and work. And yeah, hopefully that's been of some use. If it has, give the video a like. If you want to see more about the Panasonic GH6, then please subscribe to the channel.